And welcome, this is Baller Scuba with part zero of Let's Play Mass Effect 2. We are going to be getting back into the Mass Effect universe. We're going to be continuing the plot that we started in Mass Effect 1. Before we actually get this underway, though, I wanted to give this opportunity for any suggestions about how I go through the second game here. I will say, though, that you will need to keep it spoiler-free. I am going in completely blind once more, have no idea what I'm getting into, and I prefer it that way. So if you do have suggestions about how I should tackle something or how you want me to approach a certain situation or the game as a whole, please try to keep it as spoiler-free as you can. With that said, I am going to be talking about a few things that I will be doing in this game. Number one is not dealing with Mass Effect 2 Genesis. Apparently, I don't have enough points in order to get that activated anyway, but we are just going to be moving forward with the choices that we already made in the Mass Effect 1 Let's Play. We're going to be moving forward with that character as well. In terms of the options here, which are hidden in the extras menu, I'm going to be doing it on veteran combat difficulty. I feel like that's a good difficulty setting for me here. I'm going to keep the auto level off. Subtitles, of course, mandatory. We're going to let the squad kind of take care of themselves. They're going to just automatically use their most effective powers. And then the autosave, always a good option. I will hard save as we go forward, though, definitely. When it comes to the graphics, I have the brightness as high as it will go. Hopefully that works out for the best. And I'm gonna leave the film grain off. I didn't like that in the first game, so I'm gonna assume that I don't like it in this one either, but I have not tested it out. Maybe we'll do that in the first session at some point. But that's the way that I have that going. Also, I have the dialogue a little bit louder than everything else. Yeah, I need to keep it pretty low. This game was pretty loud when we started. But that's pretty much how I'm gonna go there. When it comes to the character that we're going to be bringing forward, I will show you Mariah here and all of the impactful decisions that we made in the first game. So if you have not watched the previous Let's Play, don't want that spoiled for you, I suggest you stop now. But we're going to head in and import Mariah here, and we'll go over what we did with her in the previous game. And that's what we're going to use moving forward. Here we have Mariah Shepard, level 50. I believe that was max. I don't believe I could have gone higher than that, but it's been a while, so maybe I was wrong, but 50 seems like way too round of a number for me to have just gotten that and it not be the maximum level. All right, so let's import in Mariah. That took a little work for me to get her in here, but I was able to get that done. I do have to say one thing. When it comes to this game, I was checking the sound levels and things like that. It seems like, like I said, these are the options moving forward. It seemed like they wouldn't let me skip the cutscene, which is normally fine, but I also couldn't just hard quit the program. I thought that was a weird decision on their part, but small stuff so far. So we have Mariah Shepard. She is level 50. She is a Sentinel. She has a psychological profile that is Paragon. Apparently, all the previous stuff that we did with her being a renegade kind of to start kind of disappeared because I went mostly Paragon throughout the entire game. Then we have the status of Rex. Or not Rex. Survived the mission on Vermeier. Of course he did. He was strong. And I kind of went out of my way to do it. But unfortunately, we do have one character that is missing in action. I had a choice there, and it was Caden, I believe is how I ended up saying that the most. Caden Olenko was killed on Vermeier, and the Council was lost during the attack on the Citadel. Notice, once again, like from this screen, I cannot go back. Like, I have to move forward. As a result, I witnessed the opening cutscene. I'll be the first to tell you, though, that I didn't get much out of it, so there's no spoilers for me there. But that is all that I have seen. With that said, I hope you guys do look forward to Let's Play Mass Effect 2. We will get this started shortly. Once again, if you have any comments, suggestions, or questions, this is the time for it before we get underway. But I hope you guys do look forward to it. and I hope to see you in the upcoming Let's Play.